Wow, God is a great God. God is a good God. He's full of mercy all the time. He never fails. He never changes. He keepeth covenant. He loves us. Very caring Father, this day, wherever you are, just go ahead and appreciate this God. Yes, just go ahead and appreciate him. Express your love to him. Call him by his name. Give him all the praise. Give him all the honor. Father, we love you. We adore you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your power. Thank you because you are the Lord that keepeth covenant. We give glory to the Lord. You reign. We give glory to the Lord. You reign. We give glory to the Lord. You reign. Adoration to the Lord, he reigns. Adoration to the Lord, he reigns. He reigns. He reigns. He reigns. Adoration to the Lord, he reigns. Most High God, we bless your name, honor you. Lord, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Thank you for the privilege of seeing another day. May your name continue to be praised forever in Jesus' name. As we go into your word, we ask that you speak to us expressly. May your name be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. Read good in Jesus' name. Today, Tuesday, May 28th, by the special grace of God, we will continue in the topic that we have been looking at, the power of angelic intervention, part 4. The power of angelic intervention, part 4. Now, our memory verse for today is Luke chapter 2, verse 10. Luke chapter 2, verse 10, and it says, "The angel said unto them, Fear not." Please take note, we are looking at the power of angelic intervention. And that memory verse said, "And the angel said unto them, Fear not. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people." Now, you will see in this verse, one of the assignments of God's angel, one of the operations of the angel of God among humanity. So the angel of God, they are messenger. When you look at the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, you will see the operation and the activities of angel of God. But one thing you must know, that we have God's angel and we have evil angels. But for the purpose of this teaching, we are looking at the power of our angelic intervention, talking about the angels of God. Now, the angels of God are bearers and carriers of divine message. That's the first lesson that we can pick from that verse of the scripture we have just read now, that the angels of God are bearers and carriers of divine messages. They are God's own messenger. And anytime they pay a visit to anyone, anytime they pay a visit to any nation, anytime they pay a visit to a family or to a community, they come with a message from the Lord. The angel of God, they intervene in human affairs. They always intervene in human affairs. That's another lesson from that verse of the scripture. Another lesson is that this angel of God, they bring important messages from God to man, like I said before. They bring important messages to man, to individual, to family, or to nation. Now, we had a lot of people in the Bible that had angelic visitation. And as a result of that visitation, their lives, their home, never remained the same. In the book of Luke chapter 1, you will read the account of Mary. Mary had angelic visitation. And as a result of that, her story changed, her life changed, everything about her life changed. When you talk about a man called Samson, we read in the Bible that angel also announced the coming of Samson and told his parents his divine assignment as a judge and deliverer of Israel. So Samson birth came, but the angel announced the birth before his arrival. And they also told the parent the kind of child, the kind of person, and his assignment on it. So no, we are talking about the power, the benefits of angelic intervention among men. Also, a man called Gideon, an angel also announced the destiny of Gideon to him. In fact, Gideon was ignorant of himself. But when the angel came, the angel announced, making him to understand that he's a man of valor. He was even confused when the angel called him the man of valor, because he said, nothing looked like what the angel just said. But sometimes when the angel visits you, you will discover your real identity. I am praying for my friend that is listening to me right now, that the angel of the living God will visit you in the name of Jesus. I said today, you will receive an encounter from the angel of the living God, and that encounter will lead to transformation, will lead to victory, will lead to divine assistance, will lead to celebration in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Also, you will remember the account of Abraham. Abraham also had an angelic visitation. You know? Yes, Abraham had an angelic visitation. Also, angel spoke to Joseph in the dream. And that's one of the reasons why he was able to accept Mary, because that was an encounter with the angel of God that gave him conviction concerning the pregnancy that the wife carried. You will receive angelic visitation that will lead to peace of mind in the name of Jesus. I said you will receive an angelic visitation that will lead to your peace of mind. You will receive an angelic visitation that will lead to your peace of mind in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let's go on a short break and I'll be right back. God bless you.
We're taking the drones of destruction to the stronghold of the enemy. as we conclude the dynamic trio attack with this 7 ballistic agenda to realign our destinies and crush every hidden satanic agreement on your family. Dismantle the evil platform prepared for you by your ancestors. Disgrace unfinished family battles. Recover known and unknown stolen possession. Deal decisively with cryptic demons. Receive power to arise and shine. Receive the anointing of divine acceleration. It's the June edition of Power Must Change Hands. Theme, Deep Deliverance. Part 3, The Conclusion. Dr. D.K. Olukoya, the General Overseer, Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries, will be ministering live from the Prayer City, Kilometer 12, Lagos Ibadan Expressway, Nigeria, 1st of June. 2024. 0700 WAT. Don't miss this program that will crush every stronghold from the depth. The June edition of BMCH Deep Deliverance. Part 3, The Conclusion. This program will be made available in all our social media platforms: Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and Mixlr. Don't forget MFM Television on IS20. Come fast and believe in God for an uninterrupted divine intercession. Jesus is Lord. Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries. Surely the Lord is here.
Praise the Lord, dear friend. God bless you and welcome back. We are still looking at the power of angelic intervention. It is very important for us to note that God uses many means to intervene. Yes, God uses many means to intervene. He uses many means to change things. He uses prophets who announce his word, and sometimes he sent angels to announce his word. So God can use any means. Please, I want us to take note of the following lessons also. Lessons from the scriptures about angels of God. That is for you to benefit, for you to receive, for you to really have this encounter with God's angel. Certain things must be in place, and there are lessons picked from the pages of the scripture concerning the activities and the operation of the angel. So they can give us strength when we are weak. The angel of the living God has the capacity to give us strength when we are weak. They can help us to find our way when we are lost. The angel of God can help you to find your way when you are lost. I remember many years now, went for an assignment, a ministry assignment in a particular village in Nigeria. And when we got to that town, and that was our first time, myself and my team, it was a local area. So we find it difficult to even locate where we were going. And I remember that day, we have prayed very well because of the assignment we were going for. We got to the junction of the town. And while we were still contemplating which way should we move to, a madman came closer to the car, and he just used his hand to hit the car where we parked. And he looked at us, a very stark, naked madman. He used his hand to hit the car, and he said, "Missionaries, you are welcome. I know why you are here, and I know where you are going. You can take this road. take this place, turn this way, and turn this way. It was strange to some of the people with me, but one way or the other, I understood that, yes, it's just a confirmation. But looking at the man, he looked like a madman. But God can use anything, any situation to talk to his people. So sometimes God can use something that looks foolish or stupid to speak to you. Now, they can also help us to find answers to our questions. The angels can also help us to find answers to the questions in our heart. These are points from the Bible based on the operation of the angel. Angels, they are always with us when we are going through difficult times. They are always with us when we are going through difficult times. They can help us get through tough times by giving us comfort and support. Angels, they protect us, they guide us, offer us great inner wisdom and healing messages. That's the power and function of this angel. Angel will help you in whatever spiritual situation you find yourself. So it is very important and very crucial for us to know that the angels of God are always there to assist us. But you can make a demand for their help. How do we activate the assistance of angels as Christians? We're talking about the power of angelic intervention. Right? There's a particular page in the Bible. Over the night, one angel was sent to assist God's people. And that singular angel killed 185,000 over the night. I am praying for you. Whatever conspiracy against you in the middle of the night, the angel of the Lord will go there on your behalf and destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So for you to benefit from angelic operation and assistance as a child of God, please take note. Just go about your mission in obedience. Whatever mission, whatever assignment that God has given unto you, go about it in obedience, following the pattern that God has given unto you. Number two, which is great, let God decide if He wants angel to. Sometimes you can make a demand, but sometimes you can allow God to decide if He's sending angel. But sometimes you can make a demand for those angels. Right? Now, another thing is that we must always be careful so that we don't miss our hour of visitation with this angel. We must always be very, very careful. And also, discernment with clarity is a vital key. The ability to discern whether this is God's angel or whether this is demonic angel. Because there are times our angels are around us in human form, and because we lack discernment, we miss the hour. And there are times some angel of darkness coming like angel of light, and if you are unable to discern, you fall into their trap. So discernment is a vital key for you to benefit from the ministry of angel. Please take note. Another thing that can help us is to love and worship God with all of our hearts. Love God. In fact, your love for God is a ladder that can connect you easily to the help and assistance of angels. Right? So when you begin to demonstrate a sincere love for God, you know, it's just like a love affair between husband and wife, or between parents and their children. If you love your wife, if you love your husband, if you love your children with pure mind, you don't want to break their heart. You don't want anything contrary to happen to them. You can do anything to pretend, to protect, and to defend them. So in the same manner, if you want to enjoy the ministry of God's angel, you want divine intervention, you want angelic intervention in any situation, just demonstrate the love of God. Let the Lord know that you love him. In fact, you get to a point whereby you make God to know, Lord, I love you not because I want you to do anything for me, but Lord, I just want to say I love you. And when you begin to demonstrate a sincere and a pure love for God, he will keep fighting for you. Somebody touched the lover of God's wife in the Bible, and the Lord sent a message that you are a dead man because you have touched the wife of my lover. Ignorantly, the man was not aware, but because the man loved God. So for you to benefit from angelic intervention, show that you love God and keep growing in the love of God. Let's go on a short break, and I'll be right back. Stay blessed.
Through your handheld gadgets, you can now have access to your daily devotional. The Mountaintop Live for the year 2024, Volume 9, available through download on the Google Play Store and the iOS App Store. Download yours today. Mountaintop Live Daily Devotional, Volume 9, a life-changing encounter with a God that answered by fire. Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries, surely the Lord is here. The Mountaintop Life Daily Devotional for 2024 is now available, Volume 9. Get a copy today and some for those you care about, and leave your days filled with the presence of the Lord. The Mountaintop Life Daily Devotional, Volume 9, Life-Changing Encounter with a God That Answered by Fire. Get a copy, visit www.mfmebooks.com or any MFM bookshop near you. Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries, surely the Lord is here.
Welcome back. God bless you. Another vital key for you to explain angelic intervention. You know, if an angel show up, you must be ready to listen and pick that information. Whatever they say, please take note of this. Always check out whatever instruction you receive that is not contradicting the word of God. Please, I need to say this to everybody. I don't care whoever says this, but any instruction that you receive that is contradictory to the word of God is fake. Please take note of that. So whatever leading or instruction you get and is contradicting to the scripture, it is not genuine. So we need to be very careful. And that is where discernment is very, very important. It is my prayer that God will send his angel with good news and glad tidings to your life, to your home, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In conclusion, the angels of God, they are ministering spirits. The angels of the living God, they are ministering spirits. Once you give them a command, they are always at alert to obey, to act based on your instruction. And if you fail to give instruction to them, they will fold their hand. And I want you to give an instruction right now as you pray. Right there where you are, you will shout this loud and clear. Say, angel of miracles and testimony, visit my family today in the name of Jesus. Angels of breakthrough, angels of miracle, visit my family today in the name of Jesus. Angel of miracle, angel of breakthrough, healing angel, visit my family today in the name of Jesus. Visit my family today in the name of Jesus. Visit my family today in the name of Jesus. Angels of miracle, visit me today in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. You will shout the next prayer loud and clear. Angels of mercy and destiny fulfillment, I am available. Angels of mercy and destiny fulfillment, I am available. Locate me now in the name of Jesus. Locate me now. Angel of mercy and destiny fulfillment, locate me now in the name of Jesus. Angel of mercy and destiny fulfillment, I'm available. Locate me now. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You will shout the third one loud and clear. Angel of bountiful supernatural blessing, manifest in my life now. In the name of Jesus, manifest in my life now. In the name of Jesus, manifest in my life now. In the name of Jesus, manifest in my life now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. For somebody, you have to add this one to it. Say, angel of divine encouragement, locate me now. In the name of Jesus, angel of divine encouragement, locate me now. In the name of Jesus, angel of divine encouragement, locate me now. In the name of Jesus, angel of divine encouragement, locate me now. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I pray for somebody listening to me right now. The angel that will bring good tidings, that will bring good news to your life today, may you encounter them. May they encounter you. May you encounter them. May they encounter you in the name of Jesus. May you encounter them. May they encounter you in the name of Jesus. Wherever you appear today, evil will disappear. Wherever you appear today, evil will bow. Wherever you go today, you will be favored. You will be favored. Receive the favor of God. Receive the favor of man in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Jesus' name I pray.
God bless you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank God for the miracle of sleeping and waking up. I decree that today it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus. The Lord God that dwelleth in Zion will move you forward in a new way in the mighty name of Jesus. No evil shall befall you this day, neither shall any plague move near your camp. Wherever you go, the favor of the Almighty shall be upon you. Your life shall be plugged into the socket of divine favor, divine restoration, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. All the evil present in this day, I bind them and I cast them out. You shall not be part of the evil that is spreading around in the name of Jesus. The Lord will make you head and never the tail, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I soak the whole of this day in the blood of Jesus. I soak the whole of this day in the blood of Jesus. You are going in, your coming out shall be blessings. The hand of God shall be mighty upon you. I cover you and your family with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Have a wonderful day, beloved. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen.